my mentor. He's been everything that you can imagine. He's always been there for me. He's always been here for us children. And I'll never forget what he's done. I want to expand some of the things that my father has started, such as the Maurice Lucas School of Basketball, which is a youth organization that I had with my partner, Maher, and the Maurice Lucas Foundation. I want to continue to build and grow these organizations in a way that my father will be proud of me. I want to share some of the things that have gone on in the last 2 years. From the first day that my father found out that he had bladder cancer, I was at Morton's, out to dinner, and I got a phone call from somebody, and they said, "I'm so sorry for what has happened." And I was like, "What? What happened?" He's like, "You don't know?" I was like, "No, what?" He said, "Call your parents." So I called my dad. I was like, "Dad, what's wrong?" He goes, "Just come home and we'll talk about it." And I was like, "Dad, what's wrong? Tell me right now." And he said, "Come home and we'll talk about it." And he wanted us to be there in person to tell us. So I rushed home. We all rushed home. And he sat there and told us. I cried so hard. I feel like when he's in pain, I'm in pain. Deeply sad to hear told us he had cancer and that he needed to have surgery. 6'10", big, strong, always healthy. Very well known as the enforcer. Hit with cancer. I know that he took a bullet. And it was the first big bullet he's ever had. And for me, I thought he would live forever, and I'll grow old, and have children, and have kids, and be able to call my family up, and tell them to come over for a barbecue. I always wanted to make him proud, everything I did. And I know my sister and my brother feel the same way. From playing basketball, coming to All Pac-10, starting this new organization, helping with the foundation, to growing things, to be as big as they are now. I know that he is proud of what we have all become. He was really sick toward the end, and it was the toughest for me to see my rock, my mentor, my everything. So weak and fragile. Now I remember having to massage his feet for $5. And he used to say, "Harder, harder." He He'll never pay us. He got to a point where he couldn't walk. Could barely breathe. Stop talking. Stopped keeping his eyes open and just always slept. The last 3 days before, Emma mentioned that he was really, really sick and that everybody needs to come to the hospital. Call your brother up. Get him here from Japan. He got here within 24 hours. He arrived. They wanted to keep him at the hospital for 24 hours. The last thing he said was, before he stopped talking, the day before he passed, he said, "Pam, I want to be home." That's the last thing he said. So Pam knew, no matter what, she had to get him home. The hospital gave her the runaround, this and that. And she finally put her foot down with the help of Jim and got him home that night. The next day, we all spent the whole day together. Maurice had just got in. His sister, Amari, just got in. 2:30, Maurice arrives. Amari arrived a little bit before that. We went and picked him up. And got to the house. Everybody had their one-on-one time. He was to the point where he couldn't respond. His eyes were open. But he wasn't looking at anybody. Couldn't move. And I told him. And everybody had their one-on-one time. Everybody did. The whole family was there. The whole family was there. And my brother was the last person to arrive. He went to the room, closed the door, he has one-on-one time. And even though he wasn't responding, my brother told him how he felt about memories, about what he was going to continue to do. I was in the living room. All I could hear was my brother yelling. And then Pamela started screaming. And my sister and our family. We ran to the room. It was no longer breathing. I knew the day would come. And seeing him suffer the way he did, all I could say to myself is, "Please, Lord, please. And his suffering." He passed away. And all I could do was lay on his bed by his body, hoping and praying that he could just wake up and be okay. That didn't happen. done for ourselves alone dies with us. What we have done for others and the world remains and is immortal. Albert Pike. I relate to my father and what he has done in this community and with this family. So many people have wonderful memories. And I love to hear positive things coming from everybody's mouth. I would first like to thank the Blazers for everything they have done. They have made this transition. I can't even explain how easy they have made things. How much better. They have been there since day one with this family. Putting together the memorial service, getting the Blazer game stuff going. I've been in constant contact with everybody. And from our family, we really appreciate everything you guys have done. I'd like to thank the fans. This community all over the world for loving my father as much as we loved him. I'd like to thank our friends for all the support that they've given us, especially those that have been there countless days and nights in the hospital or at home, bringing us food. Helping getting my father to and from the hospital. And you know who you are. We thank you. I also like to thank my brother for allowing me to learn from his mistakes. And for going so hard 11 years in the Air Force. Term in Iraq, 6 months, and I know that our father is very proud of him and what he has become. I'd also like to thank my sister for allowing me to be the big brother that you needed all your life. Being your second father, I'm very proud of you for graduating from college. After all that back and forth we've done, raising a beautiful child, Maurice's beautiful child, Micaiah, sitting in front as well. I'd like to thank my mother, Rita, that has been there always. If we ever got in trouble, she'd always be there to bail us out, whether it's homework, or help with college applications, or whatever. She was always there for us. Even just to talk to. I'd also like to thank Mrs. Lucas. Now, she has been a superwoman times 20. Been by my dad's side for a lot of years, through everything, raising 3 kids that were not hers. I remember telling her, that was my second, I think it was the third time that he had gone to the hospital. I think it was after the second time he came down with cancer again. I said, Emma, thank you for everything you've done with my dad. Being here, you've taken through Ben. She goes, baby, don't have to thank me. That's my baby. She's been a rock that held my dad together this whole time, helping us raise, help raise us. And I know that my father, sick or not, had always worried about her. I remember him being in bed, couldn't walk, had just got done making him breakfast. And him had to go to LA because her mother wasn't doing well. First vacation in the year. She's basically father's nurse. And she said, my dad said to me, David, I need you to go water the plants. I don't want the plants to be dead when Kevin gets back. He was always concerned about her. He would call me up. I might not get a call for a couple days. I'm the one always calling him, so every time he called me up, I see his picture on my phone. I'd get excited. If I'm in practice, I'll still answer it. And he asked, hey, I need you to come over here and put a toilet paper holder together. Put it in Pamela's bathroom. I was like, alright. That's why you called me. He's like, yep, talk to you later. I always wanted to be what my dad has been. A handyman, always in the community, always giving back. And I want to be just like him. I know that's hard to accomplish, but I'm going to try. I just want to say to my family, everybody that's been here, that I love you guys with all my heart. All the Blazers, all the family and friends that didn't have to be here today. I want to thank everybody from the bottom of my heart, bottom of Lucas family, for coming to support us in these long days. Ever since my father was sick, I knew that if anything were to happen to him, that I would have to step into his shoes and be the man he taught me to be and hold this family together. I feel like he lives inside of me and has given me strength to carry on. And I thank him for that. Thank you.